deeper and deeper, deeper asleep, far asleep. Deeper and deeper. Fully relaxed, all muscles are relaxed, you're comfortable, relaxed. You will not be anxious or distressed, but you will remember everything and you will tell me everything.
Yes. I think I will stop. I will stop. And I have not stopped. And Betty said, look, there's a star moving. And I look and I see a star. Funny. But I said, Betty, that's a satellite. We are seeing a satellite. And then I pulled over to the side of the road. And Betty jumped off her side, on her side, with the binoculars. And I got the chain. And I hooked it to the dog on her collar. And I said, come on, Dossie. Let's get out. She jumps out. And I look toward the sky, and I look back to Dalcy and walk her around the trunk of the car. And I'm saying, hurry up, Betty, so I can get a look. And Betty passes the binoculars to me. And I see that this is not a satellite. It is an airplane. It is an airplane. You can see, I think, you can see the rows of windows. And it is airplane. And I tell Betty this and give the binoculars back to her. And I am satisfied. And I drive, and Betty is still looking, and she says, Barney, that is not plane, it is still following us. And I stop and I look and I see it is still out there, off in the distance. So I search for a place to pull off the road. And I see a dirt road to the right of the main highway. And I think it's a good place I can pull off. And if any car comes, it won't strike me. And I am thinking, this is strange, because it is still there. And Betty said, I think she said, I am mad with her, I said. I believe Betty is trying to make me think this is a flying saucer.
Was it light enough to see?
It was just a light moving through the sky. I heard no noise, and I think this is ridiculous, and Betty, it is not a flying saucer. What are you doing that for? You want to believe in this thing, and I don't. And I can't hear any sound.
No sound whatever.
I want to hear a jet. Oh, I want to hear a jet so badly.
Why do you want to hear a jet?
Because Betty is making me mad. She is making me angry. Because she is saying, look at that. It's strange. It's not a plane. Look at it. And I keep thinking it's got to be. And I want to hear a hum. I want to hear a motor.
How far away was it?
It wasn't far. It was about 1,000 feet, I guess.
1,000 feet.
1,000 feet.
Did it go back and forth, or did it go in circles like a plane does?
It would go toward the west, and without looking as if it turned, it would come straight back. It would go like a I think of a paddle and a ball with a rubber. And you hit the ball, and the ball goes straight out and comes straight back about a circle. And I think only a jet could fly that fast. And I am hoping I can find a good place where I can stop and really see this thing, whatever it is. And I see a wigwam, and I recognize this place, and I feel safe. I feel less in the barren hostility.
What is this place?
Wooden area.
What is this place?
It is Indian Head. I had been there before, and I feel comforted. But I see a familiar place, and I think I will get a good look at this, because Betty was very annoying. She was annoying by telling me to look, and I can't look. I have to drive the car. I want to wake up.
You're not going to wake up. You're in deep sleep. You're comfortable. Relax. This is not going to trouble you. Go on. You can remember everything now.
It's right over my right. God. What is it? And I try to maintain control so Betty cannot tell I am scared. God, I'm scared.
It's all right. You can go right on. Experience it. It will not hurt you now.
I got to get my gun.
Calm now. Relax. Deeply relaxed.